sort of degree to which you were surprised walking into this room if you've never encountered the idea that this kind of building is actually exists as a yard. But the fact is that if you went to every single African country, Ghana, Nigeria, Togo, Senegal, Gambia, Cote d'Ivoire, these kinds of buildings are not at all rare, not at all rare. Ethiopia, Eritrea, Kenya, Uganda, wherever you want to think. And so what that suggests is that there was a very interesting moment in the history of the African continent in which the particular kinds of buildings in this exhibition, let's call it, late mid-century modern, became landed upon in some way as the most suitable form of architecture in which to begin the process of some kind of movement towards an independent independence era, including, of course, the very moment of independence itself, which in Ghana in 1957. But let's also think about how and who produced this kind of building. And we sort of forget that these guys became incredibly young architects for the scale of the projects they were let into. And certainly, if one looks both across the English and the world and the African world, one of the things that begins to strike here, and I have seen a few, for instance, work on the Parisian connection from Marseille in France to Senegal and Cote d'Ivoire, and of course, Algeria, but also and it becomes very clear that there's a kind of experimentation going on, I'd like to say, in which young European architects, not yet really established in their own territories often, get to play with modernism in places in the colonies, effectively. And that this is one reason why, and find vast numbers of these buildings in every single one. Of course, we think of the African continent, that's what it is, as a place of broken up and fragmented into various nation states. But if you could travel throughout the continent and take these photographs, you'd be amazed by what you would be able to put together as an exhibition. It would strike you actually that in some ways, modern architecture is as much present, and maybe even more present, and I'm speaking about the 40s and 50s, on the African continent than practically anywhere else. I mean, you compare, visit a European city and travel around England, or you don't come across for this period large numbers of buildings that are actually produced as modern. And I was at an exhibition recently